So the goal of this project has been to understand and computationally model vocal imitation, which we take to be the sort of auditory equivalent of sketching in the visual domain. And this process of vocal imitation is intuitive and we do it all the time, but it's actually a really difficult task when you think about it, because the set of sounds that we can make with our vocal tract is a tiny, tiny subset of all the sounds in the world. Since our goal is really to understand the process, not just to get good results, we didn't use any sort of data-driven method, but actually tried to model from first principles what's going on. So we're trying to model how the actual vocal tract works, how it produces sound, as well as the sort of reasoning behaviors and assumptions that humans are making when they actually perform this act of vocal imitation. There are two main components to our model. The first component is a model of the human vocal tract, which models the main components like the voice box and the tongue and the lips and so forth. The second component is this communicative reasoning model, which seeks to model the sort of behaviors that simulate how when a speaker is speaking, they're not only thinking about what they're doing, but also what the listener might be thinking. We ran our model to produce synthetic vocal imitations of a bunch of sounds in the real world. For instance, an ambulance siren, a crow cawing, and a bell being struck. When we compared this to a set of real human vocal imitations, we found that human intuition matched up with what our model did quite well along a variety of interesting features, which shows that we're beginning to understand the essence of this behavior of vocal imitation. There are a few limitations to our model that we want to explore in future work. For instance, we don't currently model very well long-term temporal structures. So things like music, where that structure over time is really important, we don't currently imitate very accurately, and that's something we might want to pursue in the future. And there are sounds that humans can make that our model cannot yet make. So adding those into our vocal tract model would produce even higher fidelity vocal imitations. Now, there are other contexts other than vocal imitation where we reach for sounds that don't necessarily sound exactly like the sound in the real world. For instance, some electronic instruments evoke the idea of an acoustic instrument rather than sounding like the actual instrument itself. Or sound effects in movies evoke the idea of an object rather than sounding like the actual object. Also, in cognitive science, this work has implications for things like early language learning and the emergence of mappings of sounds that we make with our voice to objects in the world. So one of the interesting findings from our work was that when our model would make mistakes, some of these mistakes actually pertained to cases where the way in which we imitate the sound might have more to do with the language that we speak rather than imitating the actual sound itself. For instance, the sound of a heartbeat, which English speakers often imitate with something like ba-boom, our model imitated as something more like t-t-t, which is similar to the way a heartbeat might be imitated in other languages besides English. In the future, we're really excited about the implications for this work in applications like building tools for sound design, as well as on the whole, building more expressive and intuitive interfaces for artists.